Okay, thanks for the introduction, Lily, and yeah, thanks for giving the chance to present this work, which I think has the capability of some fairly powerful workflows. Like all the developers that are going to present today, the challenge at hand really is to find a bridge to exchange the data between Grasshopper and between Vasari. And I'm going to demonstrate quickly with a sample model. The approach I've taken is actually an open BIM or neutral BIM format called Industry Foundation Class. Now, this format's been used for a few years mainly for coordination of model data between various BIM software, but I've been working on it for the last 2 years. It's actually derived from the step file format, so it's actually capable of representing and associating or exchanging quite advanced shapes and geometries, more so than perhaps it's been utilized in the past. So the intent then is that when you've installed the plugin in Grasshopper, you'll get a series of components specific to building information modeling. So you can set up various inputs, including sites and buildings and those sorts of materials. And then you also then can start to build up general BIM objects of architecture or structure. And there's also the scope of services. But today with Vasari, we're more concerned with conceptual massing and those types of early stage of design. So we're just going to use a specific representation or a shape of a building outline, which we're going to send to the Vasari software. So as I said, it's a combination of effective of native Grasshopper components. And then as you build up the data or the shape, then you start to transfer into components that will create the building information that we need to send to Vasari. So what I've set up here then is a component which will represent a site, including a latitude and longitude to locate the project in the world so that Vasari can load the weather data for that particular location. And effectively what these components and the graphs that I've been playing around with can do is create a lofted shape or a section spine within the IFC data structure. The visualization of it isn't quite accurate in Grasshopper, but we'll see in a second in Vasari. The shaded representation becomes more accurate. So there's also then a few compulsory components that need to be added from the geometry view menus into Grasshopper, and that includes one to just give a name and a project, which is basically the entry point into the IFC file, some building, and then as well as a section spine, a lofted shape, I'm also generating some building stories. So I've generated, I think, something like 50 stories, which can actually then be created also within the Vasari model. So to actually start the exchange process is a text file bridge. So WGG bake, and then I can create it's basically a text file, an IFC, which then I'm going to open within the Vasari environment. So I'm going to start this, and I'll keep explaining a little bit about it as it takes a minute or two to import. When you install some primarily one button to initiate the import process of this Industry Foundation Class file, and then what this is going to do is interrogate that text file and extract the recognizable data of it as it creates. So the nice thing about IFC in some ways, if you're into verifying or knowing what the data that you have in the file, is that it's also possible in a text file, or you can also open it in some previewers that exist for IFC. So one thing though, I have used the new standard, the IFC 4 standard, because it includes some aspects like NURBS, which are useful then for getting efficient shape representations into Vasari or Revit. So the viewers aren't necessarily recognizing that. It might take another year or so as it becomes formalized. The model should come up just in a moment, and we should see that. So what it's basically created, it's opened a Vasari family template for a mass, and then it creates the section spine curves, and then we'll open that conceptual massing shape that's then available to start doing the analysis of energy or wind within the Vasari environment. So just to quickly explain then, it's capable of some shape representations, including extrusions, sweeps and lofts, and there is some work I've done on adaptive components, and you can associate materials and bits and pieces with it. I am looking to add more and more features, so If you're looking to do particular model transfers and exchange particular data, then please get in touch and I'll be happy to advise. Okay, so that's basically my introduction. I'm sure we can move on to the next plugin.